Greetings, everyone. This is Queen Ifama, and I am the Truth Terrorist. And today I want to talk a little bit about trends. You know, because I watch different trends, and I see, you know, how many people, just like they jump on bandwagons, that's how people jump on trends. You know, like when they first start, people start wearing weaves, you know, weaves and wigs and things like that. They were, you know, you would think it was something new, but it wasn't. But you could tell people who are followers. See, this is, trends always bring out the follower. I could tell the follower by the trends, right? So the first you had people getting all these piercings. I mean, it's black folk getting their lips pierced, their eye pierced. Now, they're following a trend, okay? Now, who knows where that trend started? But the fact that it hasn't always been lets you know that there are people who are just sitting waiting for something to happen. Like, remember when they were doing those, what do you call them? When they was those challenges? Man, look, it's so easy to get people to just jump in and do something. I'm just amazed at how manipulative people can be. No, not manipulative, how manipulated people can be. That's why I stay away from humans. Because the majority of you, you don't think for yourself. Other people think for you. Other people set your fashion style. They set your value system, your morals. You don't even use your own common sense. You use some other common senses that have been put out there for you. And I watch trends. So I watch these things, the tattoos. Then I watch the piercings. Then I watch the weaves. Then I watch everybody getting these different colors in their hair. But they're following a trend. Now, I remember years ago, I used to see that shit years ago, but it wasn't on black people. Okay, you know, on like punk rockers or motorcycle gang people or, you know, something to that degree. But you put that shit on a damn celebrity, and black people in particular are gonna follow that shit. I mean, to the letter. Now you got women wearing these long ass eyelashes like brooms on their damn eyes when God gave them eyelashes. And you say, well, damn. When did that start? You know, this whole thing with the makeup thing. When did that start? And I'm gonna tell you, a lot of these women, this is not to trash, you know, my trans sisters, okay, and homosexual divas, okay? This is not to trash them, especially the men who dress like women. Because they're the ones who create they know how to couture their faces so they can look more feminine. And so they got women out here couturing their faces. They're already feminine. They already have feminine features. But these women are now putting on all this fade and block. And boy, I saw one woman. She put so much shit on her face on Facebook. I was like, my God, she's going to have a chisel and hammer to take that shit off at night. I mean, that woman put on layer after layer of stuff. Now, mind you, at the end of the day, she looked fabulous, just like she could go right onto a movie set. Well, guess what? That's what that kind of makeup is for. It's for television, okay? It's not for walking around in the street every day, all right? Wearing fake eyelashes, that's okay when you're going out and party, but to work? No, I don't think so. Okay, some of these things I see are just absolutely ridiculous, you know, and people cannot, they don't have the discernment. This is what I'm seeing. They don't have the ability to discern what's party wear and what's work wear. You know what I'm saying? They're wearing the same things they wear to work, you know, to go out and party, or well, vice versa, actually. You know, or to church or something like that. And I mean, this is just not our young people either. This is some old ass people that I see now walking around with them thick ass eyelashes on their damn eyes. Okay, I mean, come on. I be like, come on now. You old. You're an older woman. You're supposed to set an example. These are kids, young people. They experiment. When I was younger, I experimented. Okay, with various styles and designs and, you know, crazy looking things. My relatives will say, wow, that is crazy. You know, I used to wear them skirts all the way up half my thigh, boots up half my thigh. You know, I still wear the big Afro wig because I will never give that up. But because I think that's a link to my past is when we had Black Power, baby. But anyway, so, you know, I wear all them kooky colors and, you know, all that stuff there, but I was young. Ain't a winner. I'm gonna don that shit now. Okay? But I see older women. I'm talking about women in their 50s, 60s. I mean, they're following the trends of younger women. Younger women don't have nothing to look up for. Because I remember when I was younger, I used to look at my mom and aunts and all this stuff. And I'd be like, they used to wear their stockings, their heels. They had their purses that matched their shoes. You know, they just had fashion down pat. Okay, today, look, you can't look to your mama or your grandmother today because she around here looking like you in her Speedos and shit. You know her? She around here looking like you. You don't have nothing to emulate, okay? Brothers, don't you start laughing because I got something for your ass too. Now I'm going to take your ass all the way back. Remember? Okay, first I'm going to talk to both of y'all. Everybody. I'm talking to everybody right now. Remember the babies? Remember babies used to wear those little hats with the balls on the top and the ear flaps that come down? Well, you know, now they got old-ass people wearing them. I call them baby hats. Grown-ass men in baby hats. I mean, it's unbelievable. I'm like, those are baby hats. Remember they used to have y'all around here walking around sucking pacifiers and shit? I'm telling you, y'all will follow a trend. It's unbelievable to me. Walking around, sucking on pacifiers, baby bottles around your neck. I mean, they just infantized you so slick that you think it's a style. You know what I'm saying? And then you got older people emulating and you ain't got nothing to look up to. Look, y'all don't remember when boys used to wear short pants, do you? Little boys. You know, little boys? Your mom used to put you in little short pants and your little white socks and your hard bottom shoes. You know what I'm saying? Nah, you got grown-ass men walking around here with them short-ass pants, with them pants on just below their knees. You know, just looking like kids. Grown-ass men. The young people don't have anything to emulate. The young men don't know how to dress when they grow up because the men, the grown men, are looking just like them. You know, hats all backwards, twisted to the side. I mean, these is grown people. Our children, boy, they got very few models that let them know when you've approached adulthood, now this is how you dress, daughter or son. You know, it's just like this complete infantile rollover. It's unbelievable, the things that I see. And I'm saying to myself, I wonder, do anyone else see this? You know that, you know, you look at these reality shows, and this is where you're getting your fashion from. This is where you're getting your fashion sense from. Now the men, I don't know where they are, because the men on those programs do not dress like that. But I think they're getting their stuff from the rappers, probably. You know, because they be having those little short pants. Sometimes it should be so ridiculous. I be like, these men don't know how they done baby-fied themselves. They don't know how slick these advertisers in this society in whole. And this is just not Black men. This is all these younger men in particular. But I'm talking about older Black men are doing it. That's what's killing me. And our children suffer most for role models, for some kind of signal that says, hey, now I'm adult. Now I am an adult, not just by my age, but how I dress and how I carry myself in society. But no, honey, you got them 40 and 50 years old. Their pants are sagging. Their heads are twisted to the side. They got 1,000 necklaces on and all, I mean, just all kind of shit. You know, and some of them, and depending on what area of the country you're in, some of them got these things in their mouths that they call grills. You know, just metal in your mouth. I can imagine how your breath smell. You know, it's unbelievable. And you want to call yourself a man? Honey, I look at you and say, you ain't nothing but a little boy. That's how I look at you. You a little boy. And not only that, head, you're walking around here with your shoes untied. Grown ass men with your shoes untied. You know, and oh my God. And don't talk about shoes. You will go and put on some $400-$500 sneakers to wear out to a party. Man, don't y'all dress up anymore? Wear a nice pair of slacks, a nice shirt. You know what I'm saying? Cufflinks. Y'all don't even wear cufflinks anymore. Man, that was slick. That was so classy. Cufflinks, tie clips, you know, nice ties, iron pressed shirts, belts that match your shoes. I mean, you find very few brothers that dress like that these days. You know what I'm saying? Even if you look at the, like I was looking at the comedy program on YouTube, not YouTube, but Netflix the other day. You know how they had those comics with D.L. Hughley and all? Them comics was sharp as Dick was when Hattie died, and they look like grown-ass men, okay? They look like grown men. Now, you know, we could get fly with it. Black folk can. The suit was matching the shoes, the tie, I mean, everything. But they wasn't coming out there in them pants hanging and short-ass pants on with they sagging down and, you know, big-ass buckles on their pants and shit. They didn't do that. That's for young people. That's how you determine who's the youngers and who's the olders. You know what I'm saying? Who's the adults now? You know, who have now grown up to be responsible people. You know what I'm saying? Y'all need to quit filing folk. There's a protocol, and when you grow up, you dress a certain way. We need to reestablish that. That when you grow up, you dress a certain way. I mean, I see, boy, honey, you wouldn't believe, I see grown-ass women, I think they call themselves studs. They dress just like the young boys do. Short-ass pants, big-ass belt buckles, you know, wife beaters, what they call a wife beater. Lord knows, if I was a woman, I would never date a man that wore one of those, okay? But, you know, I mean, these women looking like guys, not really, because they got breasts hanging on under these damn wife beaters and these pants that come, you know, halfway their legs. You know what I'm saying? Looking like dudes. You know, and I'm like, there is nothing for the young people to emulate. You know, seriously. You know, especially anyone that they would probably respect. You know what I'm saying? Because the people aren't dressing like adults. You know, and a lot of these people that's walking around here are in their 40s and 50s looking like that. You know, like I said, I don't mind for the young people, you know, in your teens or early 20s. I can understand that. But when you go over 25 and your ass is dressing like that, you a goddamn retard, in my opinion. You know, you're just retarded. You know, and sisters, I mean, you just like, I ain't through with you. You know, you're just like, boy, I'm telling you, you know, there are certain things, you know, in my age, I'm not going to wear. Okay? I mean, seriously. If I was to put on something that was over my knees, I would have leggings under it. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I see some of the most outrageous shit. I see cracks of people's asses. Women. I'm like, I can't believe it. You know, you see part of your big ass bellies. I'm like, don't y'all have no shame? Don't y'all want to, you know, kind of mask that shit? You can mask it and still look good. You know what I'm saying? But some of y'all just be nigga with it. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you just all out there. You come out without a bra on. I mean, breasts just flopping every damn where. It's unbelievable. You gotta have some class. I mean, see, this is what you call class, sisters. See, there's a classy woman and there's a trashy woman. You know what I'm saying? You can always tell by the way she dresses, how she carries herself. You know, you leave out the house, you got spots and shit all over your clothes. You haven't even taken the time to comb your damn hair. You know, it's unbelievable. And the reason I'm speaking on it is because I see so much of it. I mean, it's like an epidemic of retardation. You know what I mean? I mean, it's just like we live in a society where people just don't care. I remember saying in another video that there's an a sign in Africa, in some place in Africa, that when people didn't comb their hair, they were in some kind of psychological distress. And I'm telling you, we got a whole 2 generations of people who don't comb their hair anymore. Now, that tells me that we're in some psychological distress. Now, some of them are going with a style, and I can tell the ones who do, and I can tell the ones who don't. Because the ones that's going for the look or the style, you could tell their hair is healthy. You could tell they put oil in it. They just mushed it up. But they did something with it with their hands. But those who are just rolling out the bed, hair all dusty, coming all down the street thinking they're looking good, I'm like, uh-uh, you look like you're in mourning. That's what you look like in Africa. Like, you're an African in mourning. That's what you look like to me. You're coming out without your hair comb. I mean, it's unbelievable. You know, and I'm going to tell you, see, that's from hanging around being in integration. Because, you know, white folks can lay down and get up and just run their hands through their hair and go on out the door. Okay, but black people, you actually have to comb your damn hair. Okay, you got to groom yourself, okay? We are the grooming people. Do you know we are the only 100% human beings? Did you know that? The rest of them, everybody else besides African people are part Neanderthal. Did you know that? And I saw the trend coming with that too. Because at first, white folks was not claiming to be no damn Neanderthal, okay? Because they said that the Neanderthal was all the words you can use to describe what a Neanderthal was. But then they put some new narrative to the Neanderthal and said that the Neanderthal possessed some type of intelligence. So now white folks are, you know, white scientists and stuff. Now they're associating themselves with the Neanderthal. But we knew it all the time, didn't we? We sure did. We knew that they weren't all of us. All right. But anyway, back away from that. Okay. I just thought I'd throw that in as a sidebar. But I'm telling you, we got to set some standards in our community. We had them, but we thought they was all fogey and all phony and stuff. You know, remember with the in the 80s with that come as you are shit to the church. Now they are coming as they are to the church. No respect whatsoever for the house of the Lord. They come in looking any kind of way. Now, they got it twisted. Because that was done because people were so caught up in how you looked in the church, how you dressed in the church, and how people would feel bad because they couldn't meet the standard. And other members of the church would look down on them. And so they said, well, just come as you are. Don't worry about these people. You know, just so people start coming as they were. But guess what? They start staying as they was. They start staying as they was. They didn't try to upgrade as they got into the Lord and the Lord started blessing them and things like that. And they could look a little better and feel a little better. No, they just roll out the bed and roll on the church. They said, well, at least I came to church. No, you got to have respect for the house of the Lord. If that's your house of the Lord, the mosque or whatever, you got to have respect for your religious places. I mean, that's what I would do if I was in them. I would respect that place because this is where I interact with my God. But oh no, I remember one time when I was searching, okay, and I had went to this church. Man, look, this woman in front of me, you know, sitting in a pew. This woman, this was a long time ago too. This woman was sitting in front of me. And she stood up and she had on, this when baby fat was popular, she had on jeans that you could see the crack of her ass, and her ass was big, and on the back of her jeans said baby fat. I mean, right in church. Now, I know damn well you can go to the secondhand store and get a nice skirt, a nice blouse, or something to wear to the church. Okay, but no, no. Now, the only thing that I, concession that I gave was that this may have been her first time there and this all she had to wear. So I don't know if she came next Sunday and she, you know, wore something different. But all I'm saying is that we have to start having some standards. And our standards have just went out the door. You know, it just, I don't know. We just don't have no parameters, no guidelines anymore. Everything is a blur. You know what I'm saying? I see people going to church in flip-flops. I mean, I be like, golly, don't y'all have respect for y'all house of the Lord? That y'all say that's the Lord? Oh, so you think, oh, so Jesus, Jesus don't care how I look. And you're right about that. But it's a psychological thing. You know, it's also a psychological thing. That's what all that dressing up and all that stuff is you taking care because you're going someplace special, okay, which is to church. Or if you're going to the mosque or something, you have your mosque clothes all ready. You know, so you can, now they don't come in the mosque looking like that. I just got to put that on record. You don't come as you are in no mosque. Not if you're a member, you don't. Okay, I mean the Nation of Islam or any mosque. If you in a secular Muslim temple, your ass gonna be covered up. Okay, that's just how that works. All right, so the Muslims, you know, I think they got a whole different protocol than them Christians, cause them Christians is just an open the door and lower the standards. That's what they've done. You know, and I just think we need to talk about it, cause don't nobody talk about that. We see it, but we don't talk about it. You know, you click your tongue, but you don't say nothing about it. Because, you know, well, we just got to, you know, we get Jesus accept everybody. Yeah, Jesus does accept everybody, but that Jesus ain't the issue right now. The issue is that there has to be some kind of protocol. Protocol in dress, protocol in speech, protocol in everything, particularly when you're going to worship your God. I mean, come on now. And then that shit is supposed to spill over in your everyday life. But if you just roll out your everyday life in the church and it's all the same, you get confused. That's why people do the shit they do, because they don't have no boundaries whatsoever. None. Okay? I mean, you know, I just got to tell it like it is, y'all. You know I do, right? And I've been seeing some stuff and I've been quiet. And I'm like, nah, I ain't going to say nothing because, you know, people get all upset. Their feelings get hurt, you know, and stuff like that. Then they come on my page with all that bullshit and I have to block them and all that kind of stuff. But then I'm like, nah, I'm not going to do that because somebody has to say something. Somebody has to say something. Black people in particular, we used to be the neatest people on the planet. We were the people that you would see that dress up to go downtown to the store, okay? You know, and definitely the church, your little white socks with the ruffles around the edges, your little patent leather shoes, your hair was curled, and now, man, look, they barely combing their heads, the little girls' heads, when they go to church. For real. You know what I'm saying? All nappier and, you know, got naps around the edges. You know, we used to just comb the edges out so that, you know, because it looked presentable. Not that, you know, naps is bad. I'm just saying you could tell it ain't been combed. Okay? I'm an advocate for combing your damn hair. All right? And I think that we just done slipped. Black folk done slipped. That's because now, let's go back to that African, thing over in Africa where they say that when you don't comb your hair, if you see someone who isn't combing their hair, generally they're in mourning. And I believe black people since the 80s are in a perpetual state of mourning. Okay, perpetual state of mourning. All right, because a lot of things weren't realized or actualized for them, but there were things that they could have done themselves since the 60s. Just didn't do it. You know, and it's carrying on. And now the younger people blaming older people for not doing it. And the older people are saying, hey, you got opportunity. Get your ass out there and do it. Then quit complaining. You know, so, man, look, it's 6 in 1 hand and half in the other, half a dozen in the other. But I just had to put it on record that this is what I was thinking about today as I'm doing my damn videos. Because I'm saying to myself, Lord, that's why I stay away from y'all. I stay as far away from humans and only interact when necessary. Okay, because I know that your followers, if I'm in a crowd of you, anything could jump off and everybody will just join in. And I have a hell of a time trying to get out of the mix. You know what I'm saying? That's why I be like, Lord, have mercy, please. You know, somebody wake up. I just want somebody wake up because I had to wake up. But the thing about it is I've never really been a follower. See, I've never followed the fashion trends. You know, like, oh, it's this spring, so everybody's wearing blue. It's blue this spring. Now, that is the fashion color. No, I've never been into that. I wear whatever fucking color I wish, okay? I wear cotton in the wintertime and cotton in the summertime. I wear whatever I want. I don't have summer clothes and winter clothes. I wear whatever fits. I wear whatever fits and whatever looks good and whatever feels good. That's how I've always done it. You know, I've always had a mind of my own. I've never been one that followed people. The last time I followed somebody when I was 14 years old, it taught me a lesson. I almost got raped. So I'm like, head to the no, I follow no one anymore. You know, I got out of it too. But guess what? It could have happened. It sure could have happened because I was following somebody out over there. You see what I'm saying? I learned then, don't you follow people. Because people will lead your ass to hell or hell-like place. You'll think your ass was in hell. Okay? And that's what I taught my daughter. You don't follow people. You think for yourself. You weigh out the consequences of whatever decision that your ass go make. You got 20 seconds and even less to look at the consequences of your decision. Well, if I do this, this will happen, or this could happen. Or you got to weigh the shit, and then you got to be responsible for your decision. So anyway, y'all, with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist. I hope y'all having a wonderful day, because I most certainly am. Peace, everybody.